Hello guys, my name is Kiki and in this video we are going to work on another switch which was sent here by one of my friend. He tried to take it apart but he could not repair it, so he asked me if I would have time, if I could repair it. I can tell you that this is in a really really bad shape, with a lot of scratches. The screen itself is separated already from the case. He put a sticker and it does not turn on. A lot of scratches on the back. This screw is missing. So let's see what we have got. Let's see at first the USB port. I think I will switch to the microscope because I can see something in it. So as you can see, there is some green stuff in it which looks like water damage. So maybe at the end I have to replace also the USB port. But the pins itself look like they are okay. They are not loose or something like this, as I see. Let's see the other side. This side is quite similar. There is some green stuff on it, but at least the pins are not crossing each other. Maybe if I just clean it up it will be okay, but at the end I will decide. Maybe I will just replace it. Okay, so I will switch back to my camera. Okay, so let's connect it to the charger. So it's charging with 480 milliamps, which is a normal slow charging. Let me flip it over. It's the same. Let's try to turn it on. It told me that it's not turning on, so I assume this is the case. And yes, I cannot see anything on the screen. So I think I will just go on and take it apart. So as you can see, it's in a pretty bad shape. It's like dirt and mud on it, a lot of dust everywhere. It's just disgusting, to be honest. Let's see what can we see inside. Cannot see anything obvious for the first time. It looks like the battery is extremely bulged. I don't know how well you can see, but it's wavy. It's definitely not normal how it looks like. Sure, let me try with a normal good battery. The though I don't think it will solve the problem, because it looked like it was charging perfectly. So let's try to turn it on. Cannot see backlight, so I'm pretty sure it's not on. Yes. Yeah, it's not turning on. So let's start with some measurements. I will switch over to my microscope, and then you can also see better. Okay, so battery disconnected. Multimeter in continuity mode. First, let's check the fuse, although I'm pretty sure it's okay because it looks like it's charging perfectly. Yes, it's okay. And then one of the probe on the ground. And then let's go to M19. Let's look at... Okay. So this capacitor, this bottom one, belongs to P13 USB on the back. Usually if these capacitors, this top side of this capacitor is shorted, this means that the P13 USB is shorted, or at least there is something shorted on the 3.3 line. No short here. No short. This ground. No short. This is ground. No short. And no short. Okay. So let me just check this little filter here. Okay. And okay. There are these small diode arrays are still in. This could also cause some troubles. So what I'm going to do is I will remove the board from the frame, and I will go to the P13 USB. Sorry. Okay, so here we are at the back of the board. Look at this. How much dust is on this board. It's crazy. Let me do then some measurements in P30 USB. Again, one probe on ground. We are in continuity mode. And this capacitor, this belongs to the one between next to M92. Usually this means that this P13 is shorted. If I remove P13 USB and this capacitor is still shorted, then we have a big trouble. Then we might have a CPU issue. Let's measure also the filters. Okay, so it looks like our first filter is blown. both sides of the first filter is blown. This is quite normal that this first one is failing. This one is okay. Okay, so we have a burn filter here, or a blown filter here, and I'm going to pull P13 USB. As soon as I pull, I will measure if all short is gone on the left side of this capacitor, and if yes, then we will be happy. If not, then we are in trouble. So let's pull P13 USB. Okay, so now P13 USB pulled. Let's measure this capacitor, and our short is gone. Great, and most probably our problem is only P13 USB because the short is gone. Okay, so now I will pull a filter from a donor board, and I will grab a new P13 USB, install it, and hope for the best. Okay, so everything is in its position. Now I will clean up a board. Okay, so let's do some measurement. Let's see if our filter is now connected. One point here and the other one is going here. And yes, it's connected. Let's see the other one, it's going next to it. This is also connected, okay. Okay. And let's see P13 USB. And this capacitor is not shorted. Okay, so I will put it back into the case, and I will clean it up. At first I will clean it up a little bit further, and then I will put it back to the case, and let's see if it works. Okay guys, so I put everything back together just to be able to test all the functions. I connected already the Joy-Cons. I will not put in the fan at the moment, and I will also not put the heatsink on it because I'm not sure it will work or not, and I do not want to take it apart again fully. So at first I will try with the original battery and let's see if it works. Let's turn it on. We have backlight, really good news. And we have Nintendo Switch logo, great. Great news. Touch works. A lot of games on it. Then let's see if it reads cards, game card. I have to be careful because I did not fix it. Yes, it shows up. This is my game card. And now it's off. Okay. This works. Let's see if Joy-Cons are connecting. Left Joy-Con is connected. Right Joy-Con is connected. As you can see both of them. Let's connect it to the charger. And it's charging both of them. And it's throwing 1.1 amps. So it's even fast charging. But else shall I try? I should check if it docks. Let me first put together my dock. So here is my dock. Okay. It's being recognized. No, it's not. Oh, it is. Green LED is on. Let's switch to the video capture card. And it does not dock. I think we have a trouble with the USB port, because if I move it a little bit inside the dock, then it's quite loose. And sometimes the screen is blinking up. Let me show you what I mean. No, it's black, but if I move it just a little bit, you see now the green LED is not on. And it's really really rude. No, display is on. So I definitely have to replace the USB port also. Me see inside the USB port. Maybe I will clean it up a little bit. because it was green. Let's try again, and if it still does not work, then I will have to replace the USB port. Okay, so no, it still does not work. Okay guys, so I think I will end up the video here, because I already did quite a few videos about USB port replacement. And I'm pretty sure this will be our problem, because it was green also. So I hope you enjoyed the video. If yes, please don't forget to like, share, and please don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I hope I see you next time. Bye.